from a physiological standpoint, we're reward-driven creatures. We live in the immediate present. And so from the standpoint of our evolution, we find ourselves in an environment which the human being has never previously experienced, one of extraordinary abundance and extraordinary affluence. Now, we were designed to figure out how to survive in circumstances of scarcity. So when you put an animal, or any other mammal for that matter, into a highly enriched environment, they essentially become addicted to it. And so we're driving ourselves towards the edge of our physiological limits. And what interests me is how we got there.
Today's event takes us into the question of, are we living too fast? Is this affecting our quality of life? What is the reason that this is happening, and what can we do about it? And begin the discussion.
It is a little bit of a crisis, the pace that we're asked to produce within. The pace of our society is not very friendly. It feels, for me as an artist, it feels like a nipping at my heels to get things done, respond.
The children go to school in one place, we shop in another place, we work in another place. There is no community where people know each other. And so what's happened is self-interest now is totally dominant in our country.
The most valuable thing for me would have been if I had really thought when I was younger what success was for me. Was success having $1 million in the bank and a square foot house? Or is success having a really active social life, a community of friends, enough quality food to eat, and occasional travel?
Technology can be a tool of liberation as well as oppression. If we're looking for community, if we're looking for placemaking, it's also a fight to make government responsive to those goals.
It's basically about taking the time to actually focus on what you're doing in terms of cooking and eating, and not throwing out tradition and regionality in our quest to be faster, cheaper.
Our present circumstances are entirely predictable. The question is, how can we be smart enough to get out of it?